All right, what is up, guys? This is such a nice looking problem. If we want to solve this problem, please pause the video because I'm going to solve this problem right now. So welcome to another video on prime logic. The problem setup is pretty much simple. So we have a circle, there is a triangle, an isosceles triangle inscribed inside a circle, and our job is to find and calculate the radius. So the radius of the circumcircle. So for the sake of this video, because this is one of the most fundamental and really required needed techniques of geometry, so I'm going to solve it using a couple of different methods, two or three possibly. So I will start, as always, I will start with a more gradual step-by-step approach. For those of you who are interested in that, we'll go forward for more like calculations based on formula for this specific setups. So this is an isosceles triangle, right? So let's draw the height here. So we have 5, 5, and 6. So we know that the height of this isosceles triangle bisects the base here. So we can calculate the height now. So the height, according to the Pythagorean theorem, so and this is going to be free because that bisects the base, and this is going to be also free. So we know that h, which is the height, equals, according to the Pythagorean theorem, right? Or maybe write it from the beginning. So we can say that 5 squared, which is 25, equals 3 squared, which is 9, plus h squared. So h squared equals 16 and h is 4, right? So this is a classic 3, 4, 5 side length right angle triangle. And let's draw another. So we know that based on the property that we have a chord here, and then this chord is bisected. And we know that this line, the height, must pass through the center. So at some point here, I'm not sure where, but at some point, let's say here, it is the center of the circle because this line must pass through the center, must have passed through the center because now it is a perpendicular bisector of this chord. So based on this theory and property, we can see that the line must have passed through the center of the circle. So we can, let's draw another radius here. So we know that the whole line is, the whole height is 4, the 4. And this is r, right? This is r, and also this is r. So this little tiny segment is 4 minus r. So for this triangle, this little triangle, let's write down the Pythagorean theorem one more time. So we can say that r squared, again, so this is the hypotenuse, r squared equals this side length squared, which is 4 minus r squared plus 3 squared, which is 9. So let's write it down one more time. Let's expand this relationship. So r squared equals 16 plus r squared minus 8r plus 9. So r squared, we can cancel them out. So we can say that based on this property, 8r equals 25. In other words, r equals 25 over 8. So that's the value of r using just pure geometry, elementary, high school level kind of geometry, Pythagorean theorem. So that's just it. So that's our first approach, the first method, r equals 25 over 8. So let's go with another approach. So for those of you who want faster kind of ways of calculations for exams, exam preparations, puzzles, Olympiad, this type of things. So whenever we have a circumcircle, circumcircle is a circle that circumscribes a triangle inside. In other words, we can say that a triangle is inscribed a circumcircle. So let's name, for example, this part, this the vertices is A, for example, B and C. So this is also A. So we know that in any circumcircle, this relationship is always valid. So A over sine A equals 2R. So A is the side length of this inscribed triangle, and sine A is the corresponding angle. So we can write it down as, so A is 5, right? According to this formula, A, or one of the side length, doesn't matter. So A is 5. Or the sine of corresponding angle over the sine of this angle. So what is the sine of this angle? This is a right angle triangle. The sine is the opposite over the hypotenuse. So the sine is 4 over 5 equals 2r. We can see that 2r equals 25 over 4, and r equals 25 over 8. So that's the same thing that we found earlier, much, much faster. So we had, in the previous one, we had to calculate a lot of things, but now it's much faster just using, so I think everybody should know this formula. So this is another way, another method. Let's go for the third method as well, which is, I think, also interesting. So based on the properties of the circumcircle and any inscribed triangle inside a circumcircle, we can say that, so R, the radius of the circumcircle, equals, so A, B, C over 4A. So A, B, C are the side length of the inscribed triangle. So it doesn't matter what kind of triangle it is, if this is an scaling, isosceles, right angle, equilateral, doesn't matter. So A, B, C are the side length of this any triangle, inscribed triangle. So that's the product of the side length over 4 times the area of the triangle. So this is the radius of this circumcircle. So for calculating the area, there are a couple of methods, for example. So let's write it down. So ABC, which is 5 times 5 times 6. So 25 times 6, that's 150. Or 4A. So 4A, 4 times the area. So the area of this isosceles triangle, we've calculated height, right? The height is 4 as we calculated in the first step. So 4 times 6, which is the base, is 24, and half of this would be 12. So the area of this whole triangle is 12. So 4 times 12, which is 48. So that's going to be 150 over 48. If we divide them by 6, it's going to be 25 over 8. So that's the same thing, right? So for those of you who want another approach for calculating the area, for example, in this specific setup, we have the side length, right? So you could use the Heron's formula. And this is also really interesting. So according to Heron's formula, so you could calculate the area of any triangle just using the side length. So the formula says area equals the square root of, so S, I will tell you what S is, or S minus A, or sorry, times S minus B, and times S minus C. And S is half of the circumference. So circumference, so let's write it down as just C, and it represents circumference over 2. So the circumference of this triangle, okay, that's the sum of all the side length, right? So 5 plus 5, 10, plus 6, 16, over 2, that's going to be 8. So that's the circumference over 2, or half of the circumference. And let's just substitute it here. So square root of 8 times 8 minus 1 of the side, 8 minus 5, is free. 8 minus 5 is also free. 8 minus 2, it's 2. So it's going to be 9, so 224, and then 100. And the square root of 144 is 12, right? So we calculated the area of this triangle using the Heron's formula as well. So then you could substitute it in this formula here. So 4 times 12, 48, and 150 over 48, which is 25 over 8. So that's going to wrap it up for today, guys. I think that was an interesting problem. I chose it because I wanted to show it to you using a couple of different methods, two or three methods, so that it could be, you could understand all different complexities and layers and dynamics of solving these type of things. So I want you to drop your thoughts and answers in the comments below. I want to also know how you would solve and approach this problem. So these are definitely not the only problems. There are types of solutions as well. So I want you to drop your thoughts and answers in the comments below. And I want you to like and subscribe if you haven't already. And as always, I love you guys. I appreciate you guys and see you on our next video. Prime Logic signing out.